there, Riderflex Nation. Steve Urban here with more career advice and job interviewing tips for you. And as a quick reminder, if you enjoy our podcast, please remember to subscribe to our channel and like the episodes. And on today's podcast, how to stay calm during the job interview. I want to give you some tips and also share a personal story with you. You know, sometimes people get nervous, right? They're going in for the job interview and they're thinking to themselves, oh boy, there's a lot riding on this. Oh, I gotta have this job. I gotta do well in this interview. And then they work themselves up and they get all nervous and then they end up screwing up during the interview. So I want to give you some tips around it. Based on my own experience interviewing for jobs and having interviewed and hired hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people. First, a true story about myself. Years and years ago, I was interviewing for a job down in Miami, and I got to the job interview, and I lost it. I lost my composure. I was actually sitting in front of the employer, the hiring manager. He asked me a question. I got really nervous, and I started sweating, like just started my forehead. I'm sweating. I'm dripping sweat. And then, of course, I got to thinking about the fact that I'm sweating, and then it just got worse, and then I lost my composure, and I actually excused myself and went to the restroom. Guess what? I didn't get the job. So it's actually happened to me, even in my own career. But I've learned a lot. You know, I'm 52 years old now, and I've experienced a lot and learned a lot, and so I want to share a couple of tips with you. How to stay calm. First, prepare. If you are fully prepared, if you have really truly studied the company, studied the people you're going to be interviewing with, you've brought the right material with you, you know, you have copies of your resume, you have, you know, questions that you've already prepared to ask them during the interview, you've practiced any possible question they could ask you, right? You've dissected your resume to find out what might be a weakness compared to the job requirement, and you're prepared to counter that. Just prepare. As long as you're fully prepared, most of the time you will not lose your composure. So that's number one. Number two, remember, this is not life and death, right? You're not saving lives here. It's just a job interview. Stop thinking that. You know, don't work yourself up into thinking, oh my God, I have to have this job or my life's over, right? Or something like that. It's really not life and death. So stop thinking of it that way. Even if you're unemployed, let's say you've been unemployed for 2 months, you're looking in your checking account and you only have, you know, $5,000 left and you're thinking, oh my God, if I don't get this job, what am I going to do? Don't be thinking about those things during the interview. Okay. It's not life and death. Number three. Okay. This is going to sound a little bit cheesy maybe for some of you, but I honestly believe if it's meant to happen, if it's meant to be, it will be. Okay. As long as you've done your part and you've prepared and you've done all the right things to get ready, if it's meant to happen, it'll happen. And if it's not meant to, guess what? Something will go wrong. And that's probably because it just wasn't meant for you to be there. Okay. It's not right for you for some reason. Who knows? Now, I know some of you are going to think, you know, maybe that's cheesy or whatever, but I really honestly believe that. I believe you're steered away from things that just aren't meant for you. And then my final point is this, you know, don't go into the interview worried about being perfect or answering everything perfectly. If the person interviewing you is doing a really good job, they are likely to ask you something that's going to trip you up or that you weren't ready for, no matter how much you prepared. So just remember, don't worry about being perfect. If they ask you something and you're not sure how to answer it, I would just say something to the effect of, you know what, Mr. Brown, that's a great question. I'd like to think about that one if I can and maybe get back to you. I'll follow up with you tomorrow with an email. I'd like to think about it a little more thoroughly, etc. Just answer it in some way like that to get out of answering the question right that second, if it's, you know, if it's something that has stumped you in some way. And there is your Riderflex tip of the day. We truly hope you find our material helpful and entertaining. And while our podcast can be heard across most platforms, including iTunes, Google Play, Spotify, YouTube, and SoundCloud, you can become a supporter of this podcast by visiting our show on the platform Anchor FM. That's anchor.fm/Riderflex. You can also send us your questions or suggested topics for future episodes to the email address podcast@riderflex.com or drop us a voicemail at 888-964-5876, extension 710. Visit riderflex.com to learn more about us. Thanks so much for listening, folks, and have a great day.